亲爱的兄弟姊妹们，欢迎大家回到恩典真理基督教会的线上崇拜。我是央，今天的崇拜主题是如何确认主的爱，由长谦传道为我们带来。然后在今天的传道开始之前，请让我们一起唱圣歌赞美我们的主，然后由庄为我们带来今天的祷告。那么我们开始吧。
祝你的爱 父啊，我们感谢你，因为你用永远的爱爱了我们，且用你的慈爱吸引我们。你竟差遣你所宝贵的儿子耶稣基督降卑为人，来到世人当中，好使我们得生命，并且得得更丰盛，我们才知道什么是真光。父啊，我们赞美你，因为你用这样的绝对的爱爱了我们，你竟差遣你的独生爱子耶稣基督为我们死在十字架上，好使我们得门救赎，我们才知道什么是真爱。若非你的赦罪之恩，就无一人能在你面前站立得住，因为世人都犯了罪，亏缺了神的荣耀。我们过去都得罪了你，如今却成了何等人，是蒙神的恩才成的。我们竟成了被拣选的族类，有君尊的祭司，圣洁的国度，属神的子民。我们感谢赞美你，因为我们从前算不得子民，现在却做了神的子民。从前未曾蒙连血，现在却蒙了连血。你既是这样的爱我们，就愿你的旨意行在我们身上，如同行在天上，好使我们有能力向世人传讲福音，向他们分享神的爱。又愿你复兴各处的教会，将得救的人数天天加给教会。各处的基督徒，无论是蒙平安的，无论是被逼迫的，无论是要为主殉道的，都求你保守。因我们活着是为基督活着，受苦是为基督受苦，死去是为基督而死，或生或死，没有什么能使我们与基督并他的爱分开。求你保守各处的基督徒远离新冠肺炎的危害。谢谢你保守了我们恩典真理基督教会的众人免于新冠肺炎，也谢谢你控制了澳洲和中国的疫情。求你怜悯美国人民，因他们实在是在你的面前受击打。求你把你最好的礼物，就是永生的福音赐给他们，也赐给饱受肺炎折磨的多国，因为地狱的火远比肺炎更加可怕。今天求你的圣灵运行在每一个观看这崇拜视频的人心中，无论是未信之人还是已信的弟兄姐妹，都求你使他们在崇拜当中遇见你。求你用你的恩手来触碰他们的生命，好使不信的人悔改相信，已信耶稣的人完全被你得着。求你重用你的仆人长谦弟兄，使他做你话语的出口，使他所讲的道发出生命和亮光，以致我们可以明白真理和当遵守的道。求你加力量给我们来遵守你的道，愿你使我们走在蒙福的道路中。愿一切的荣耀因你的大爱归给你，奉主耶稣的名祷告，阿们。
大家好，我是长谦传道。今天我们会继续看罗马书，请 Helen 为我们读。
罗马书五章五到十一节，盼望不至于羞耻，因为所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们心里。因我们还软弱的时候，基督就按所定的日期为罪人死。为一人死是少有的，为人人死或者有敢做的，唯有基督在我们还做罪人的时候为我们死，神的爱就在此向我们显明了。现在我们既靠着他的血称义，就更要借着他免去神的愤怒。因为我们做仇敌的时候， 且借着神的儿子的死得与神和好，既已和好，就更要因他的身得救了。不但如此，我们既借着我主耶稣基督得与神和好，也就借着他以神为乐。
There was a couple who were struggling in their marriage.
有一对夫妻在婚姻中出了问题。
So they went to see a counselor.
于是他们去见了婚姻辅导员。
And the counselor asked them, "So, what's the problem?"
那位婚姻辅导员就问他们，你们有什么问题呢？
The wife speaks first.
那妻子首先说道，
"I don't know if my husband loves me anymore."
我不知道我丈夫是否还爱我。
In a typical man's way of responding, the husband rolls his eyes.
丈夫以一种男人典型的回应方式翻了个白眼，
shakes his head in frustration，
沮丧地摇了摇头，
and tells his wife, "Didn't I tell you already when we got married that I loved you? If anything changes, I'll let you know."
丈夫对他的妻子说，我们结婚时我不是已经告诉过你我爱你吗？如果有任何改变的话，我会告诉你的。
There are a lot of people who are just like that wife today.
今天有很多人就和那个妻子一样。
They don't feel loved.
他们没有被爱的感觉。
In 2012, what is love was the top query in Google.
在2012年，爱是什么？是人们在谷歌中搜索的头条查询。
This tells us that there are a lot of people out there who are searching for true love, but can't find it.
这告诉我们，有很多人在寻找真爱，但却找不到。
There are many people who are disappointed with their marriage.
许多人对婚姻感到失望。
Disappointed with their parents.
对父母感到失望。
Disappointed with their children.
对子女感到失望。
Or disappointed with their friends.
或者是对朋友感到失望。
Some people have become so cynical about love that they don't believe true love exists in this world.
有些人对爱变得愤世嫉俗，以至于他们不相信这个世上有真爱的存在。
That is because we live in a fallen world filled with broken, imperfect people.
那是因为我们生活在一个充满着破碎、不完美的人的堕落世界中。
And when broken, imperfect people love other broken, imperfect people, what's going to happen?
而当破碎不完美的人爱上另一个破碎不完美的人的时候，会发生什么呢？
The love relationship is bound to be broken and imperfect as well.
那他们的爱的关系也必是破碎和不完美的。
But God's love is not like human love.
但是神的爱不像人类的爱。
God's love is perfect and pure.
神的爱是完美和纯洁的。
His love is sure and steadfast.
他的爱是坚定不变的。
God is not like that husband in that story earlier.
神不是我们之前说的故事中的那个丈夫。
Who doesn't know how to express his love?
不知道如何表达自己的爱。
No, he is a God who lavishes his love on his children.
不是的，神是一位将自己的爱浇灌给他的孩子们的神。
What does 1 John chapter 3 verse 1 say?
约翰一书三章一节中说道，你看父赐给我们是何等的慈爱，使我们得称为神的儿女。
And in today's Bible passage, Paul tells us that we can be safe and secure in God's love for us.
在今天的经文中，保罗告诉我们，我们可以确信神对我们的爱。
Two weeks ago, if you can remember, we looked at the first five verses of Romans chapter 5.
两周前，如果你还记得的话，我们看了第罗马书第五章的前五节经文。
Where Paul gave us the benefits of justification.
在那里，使徒保罗给我们讲了称义的好处。
Justification, remember, means God declaring sinners to be right with himself.
如果你还记得的话，称义是指神宣布罪人与他和好。
And one of the benefits of justification?
那称义的好处之一呢是什么呢？
We have peace with God.
就是我们可以得到与神和好而来的平安。
We have access to God.
我们可以直接进入神的同在。
And we have a glorious hope.
而且我们还会有荣耀的盼望。
Three benefits.
这三个好处。
But there is a fourth benefit that I did not have time to talk about 2 weeks ago.
但是有第四个称义的好处，我两周前没有时间提到。
And that is the assurance of God's love.
那就是神的爱的确据。
When we believe in Jesus, God doesn't just save us from sin and death.
当我们相信耶稣的时候，神不仅会拯救我们脱离罪恶和死亡。
He brings us into a love relationship with himself.
他还让我们与他自己建立了爱的关系。
Look at verse 5 again.
我们再看第五节。盼望不至于羞耻，因为神的爱浇灌在我们心里。
How has God poured out his love into our hearts?
神是如何将他的爱浇灌在我们的心里呢？
How can you be sure that God loves you?
你如何确定神爱你呢？
Well, Paul explains in verses 5 to 11.
保罗在今天经文的第五到第十一节中进行了解释。
And in these verses, we see that God has demonstrated His love to us in three ways.
在这些经文中，我们看到神通过三种方式向我们显明了他对我们的爱。
Through His Spirit.
通过他的灵。
Through His death.
通过他的死。
And through His life.
即通过他的生命。
First.God has demonstrated His love to us through His Spirit.
首先，神通过他的灵向我们显明了他对我们的爱。
Look at how verse 5 concludes.
我们来看看第五节是如何总结的。这里说到，所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们心里。
That is one of the roles of the Holy Spirit.
那就是圣灵的角色之一。
The Holy Spirit communicates.God's love to us.
圣灵将神的爱传达给我们。
He enables us to experience, to feel God's love in an experiential way.
他使我们能够以体验的方式去经历到神对我们的爱。
How does the Holy Spirit communicate God's love to us?
圣灵如何将神的爱传达给我们呢？
Well, just one of those things that words alone cannot explain.
这是文字无法解释的事之一。
Just like when I was still single, searching for a life partner.
就像我还是单身的时候，在寻找我生命的另外一半一样。
And whenever I asked married couples how I would know when I meet the right one, they would just answer, when you meet the right one, you know it.
每当我问已婚的人士，我怎么知道某人是否就是我要找的那个人时，他们就会回答，当你遇到合适的人的时候，你就会知道。
How will I know?
我怎么会知道呢？
You just know.
你会知道的。
That didn't seem like very helpful advice at the time.
当时这似乎不是非常有用的建议。
Until I met Helen.
直到我遇到了海伦。
When I met Helen, I can't explain why, but I just knew that she was the one.
当我遇见海伦时，我无法解释原因，但我只知道她就是那一位我要找的人。
I had this intuitive sense from the Holy Spirit that she was the one whom God had prepared for me.
我从圣灵那得到一种直觉上的感觉，她就是神为我预备的那一位。
Now I know that that's not always the case for everyone.
我知道并非每个人都会如此遇到生命的另一半。
But love is one of those things that cannot be put into words, isn't it?
但是爱是无法用语言去表达的事物之一，不是吗？
You have to experience it to know it.
你必须经历它才能知道。
The same goes for God's love.
神的爱也是一样。
If you were to ask me, how do I know God loves me? All I can say is, I know it.
如果你问我，我怎么知道神爱我？我可以说的就是我知道。
I can't explain it.
我无法解释。
That is the work of the Holy Spirit.
那就是圣灵的工作。
He enables us to experience God's love.
他使我们能够经历神的爱。
Speaking of my wife, I have to say that I'm the most blessed man on earth.
说到我的妻子，我必须说我是地球上最蒙福的人。
Because I have a wonderful wife who takes good care of me.
因为我有一个会很好照顾我的妻子。
For example, my wife knows that I'm someone who keeps forgetting to drink enough water.
例如，我的妻子知道我是一个总是忘记喝足够水的人。
So she constantly pours water for me to drink.
因此，她不断地会倒水给我喝。
Those from church will know that.
在教会里的弟兄姐妹应该会知道这一点。
Every morning, she will wake up before me to boil water so that there is water first thing in the morning for me to drink.
每天早上，她会比我先醒来去烧水，那样当我早上醒来时的第一件事就是我就会有水喝。
And throughout the day, at every hour or so, she will pour me a glass of water.
而且，一天里面大约每隔一个小时呢，她都会倒一杯水给我喝。
And speaking of water, thank you, 谢谢。看到了吗？感谢神，我有一个这么好的妻子。And that's the reason why my skin has improved so much ever since I got married.
这就是为什么结婚后我的皮肤得到如此巨大的改善的原因。
Because I'm drinking a lot more water now.
因为我现在喝很多的水。
You know, I used to have a lot of pimples on my face.
我以前脸上有很多的痘子。
Now, as you can see, my face is all smooth.
但是现在，如你所见，我的脸，很光滑。
All thanks to my wife.
这都要感谢我的妻子。
Because she keeps me hydrated.
因为她让我保持了水分。
And if you have pimples, that's my tip for you.
如果你脸上有痘痘的话，这是我给你的一点建议。
Drink more water.
就多喝水。
Every time my wife pours me a cup of water to drink, she's expressing her love and devotion to me.
每次我妻子为我倒水喝的时候，她就是在向我表达她的爱。
And that is what the Holy Spirit does for us as well.
那也是圣灵对我们所做的。
He constantly pours the love of God into our hearts.
他不断地将神的爱浇灌在我们的心里。
The word pour here is that of an overwhelming flood that never stops.
这里说到的浇灌这一词是指永不停止的永久性的洪水。
God's love is not a sporadic shower that just comes once in a while.
神的爱不是偶尔下的阵雨，只会偶尔出现一次。
No, His love is a flooding river that is always overflowing.
他的爱是一条永远不停的泛滥的河流。
The Holy Spirit then enables us to taste and experience the love of God.
而圣灵使我们能够尝到和经历到神的爱。
Have you ever read a passage of scripture where the words just jump out at you?
你是否在读圣经里的一段经文时，发现那些话正是你需要的？
And you know that God is speaking to you through those words?
而你知道神正在通过那些话亲自在对你说话。
Have you ever had your heart well up with love?
你有没有心里充满了神的爱？
That's the work of the Holy Spirit.
那就是圣灵的工作。
It is the Holy Spirit that moves, that brings God's word from the realm of abstract knowledge to personal experience.
正是圣灵将神的话语从抽象知识的领域带入了个人经历。
We need the Holy Spirit to communicate God's love to us.
我们需要圣灵将神的爱传达给我们。
And make it a personal reality in our lives.
并使它成为我们生命中的一个现实。
Without the work of the Holy Spirit, the Bible would be just dead words on a page.
没有圣灵的工作，圣经只是一张纸上的字。
And how do we receive the Holy Spirit?
我们如何接受圣灵呢？
By putting our faith in Jesus Christ.
就是通过相信耶稣。
Remember what the Apostle Peter said to the crowd at the day of Pentecost?
还记得在五旬节那天，使徒彼得对人群说了什么吗？他说，你们个人要悔改，奉耶稣基督的名受洗， 叫你们的罪得赦，就必领受所赐的圣灵。
That's a promise.
那是一个应许。
The moment you put your faith in Jesus, God sends His Spirit to dwell in our hearts, so that we have a sense of His presence and love.
在你相信耶稣的那一刻，神就会差遣他的灵住在你的心中，使你能感受到他的同在和他的爱。
In his popular book, The Five Love Languages, Dr. Gary Chapman talks about how every person has a love tank.
盖瑞·巧门博士在他的热门著作《爱的五种语言》中谈到了每个人如何拥有一个爱的容器。
This love tank is full when you feel loved.
这个爱的容器当是在当你被感受到被爱侣爱着被伴侣爱着的时候就会被充满。
But over time, it begins to drain.
但是随着时间的流逝，它就开始耗尽。
So to keep the love tank full, couples must keep replenishing that love tank in their partner's love language.
因此，为了保持爱的容器的满意，伴侣之间需要通过用伴侣的爱的语言去表达爱意，来不断地填补对方的爱的容器。
Well, let me ask you, how full is your love tank at this moment?
让我来问你，你此刻的爱的容器有多满？
Are you overflowing with God's love?
你是否有充满神了神的爱？
Or are you feeling dry?
还是你感到枯干？
How often is your love tank being topped up?
你的爱的容器多久会被充满一次？
If your love tank is running a little bit low, a little bit dry, ask the Holy Spirit to pour the love of God into your heart.
如果你的爱的容器现在里面的容量有点低，有点干，那你就求圣灵将神的爱浇灌在你的心里。
And keep coming to Him for more.
并继续向他寻求更多。
If you keep asking the Holy Spirit to fill your heart with God's love, your love tank will always be topped up.
如果你不断地去祈求圣灵去充满你的心，你的爱的容器将永远会被充满。
So the first way God has demonstrated His love to us is through His Spirit.
因此，神向我们显明他对我们的爱的第一种方式，就是通过他的灵。
The second way God has demonstrated His love to us is through His death.
神向我们彰显他对我们的爱的第二种方式，是通过他的死。
Look at verse 6.
让我们来看第六节，这里说到，因我们还软弱的时候，基督就按所定的日期为罪人死。
How would you measure love?
你如何去衡量爱呢？
I know love is an abstract concept which makes it hard to measure in a quantifiable way.
我知道爱是一个抽象的概念，很难以量化的方式进行衡量。
But what is the best way to measure how much someone loves another person?
但是确定某人有多爱另一个人的最佳方法是什么呢？
But how much they are willing to give, isn't it?
就是他们愿意付出多少，不是吗？
Because the essence of love is giving.
因为爱的本质就是付出。
And the costlier the gift, the greater the love.
礼物的代价越大，爱就越大。
Well, what can be costlier than sacrificing your love for another?
那么有什么比牺牲自己的生命要更付出更大的代价呢？
Look at what Jesus says in John chapter 15 verse 13.
耶稣在约翰福音15章13节中说道，人为朋友舍命，人的爱心没有比这个大的。
But do you know what is even more costlier than sacrificing your love for another?
但是你知道什么是比为他人牺牲自己的生命更大的代价吗？
Sacrificing your own child.
就是牺牲你自己的孩子。
Am I right, parents?
做父母的，我说的对吗？
If you were forced to make a choice between you or your child, which one would you sacrifice?
如果你被迫在你或你孩子之间做出选择，你会牺牲谁？
I have no doubt that you would sacrifice your life to save your child, isn't it?
我毫不怀疑你会为挽救你自己的孩子而牺牲自己的生命，不是吗？
Because the most precious thing in this world is our children.
因为这世上最珍贵的东西是我们的孩子。
Well, consider this. God did not spare even his one and only beloved son in order to save us.
那让我们来思想一下这一点。为了拯救我们，神连他唯一的爱子都没有保留。
The most famous verse of the Bible, John 3:16 says,
圣经中最著名的经文就是在约翰福音三章十六节里面说到，神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们。
That is how much God loves us.
神就是这么的爱我们。
He gave what was most precious to him.
他赐给了我们他最宝贵的。
His one and only son.
就是他的独生子耶稣基督。
And not only that, notice when God sent his son to die for us.
不仅如此，我们要留意的是，神是什么时候差遣他的儿子耶稣来为我们而死的。
Was it when we were in good terms with God?
是当我们与神有好的关系的时候吗？
No.
不是的。
Verse 6 says, Christ came when we were what?When we were still powerless.
第六节说，基督是在我们什么时候？是在我们还软弱的时候来的。
In other words, we were in a hopeless situation.
换句话说，耶稣是在我们处于绝望的状态。
We were under the power of sin.
在我们还在罪的权势之下。
With no ability.To please God.
没有能力去讨神的喜悦的情况下来的。
But not only were we powerless, we were ungodly.
而且他是在不但我们是不仅我们是软弱，而且还是我们还是罪人的时候来的。
Verse 6 goes on to say, Christ died for the ungodly.
第六节继续说，基督为罪人死。
We were enemies of God, in other words.
换句话说，我们曾经都是神的敌人。
How many of you would be willing to lay down your life for an enemy?
你们中有多少人愿意为敌人死呢？
We can understand why a person may sacrifice his life to save a good friend, or a parent die to save their child.
我们可以理解为什么有人可能为了救好朋友而死。或是父母为了要救自己的孩子而死。
Human beings can actually be very generous towards those whom they consider worthy of their respect and affection.
人类可以对他们认为配得其爱戴和尊重的人很去施慷慨和爱慕的心。
But the amazing thing about God's love for us is that there was nothing worthy or good about us.When God sent His Son Jesus to die for us.
但是关于神的爱的奇妙之处在于，当他差遣儿子耶稣为我们而死时，我们是不配的，我们也没什么好的。
Look at verses 7 to 8.
在第七到第八节里面说到，为一人死是少有的，为人人死或者有敢做的。唯有基督在我们还做罪人的时候为我们死，神的爱就在此向我们显明了。
You see, that is the difference between God's love and human love.
你看到吗？这就是人类的爱与神的爱之间的差异。
Human love is based on the attractiveness of the object.
人类的爱是基于物体的吸引力。
The more attractive the object, the more we love it.
那个物体越有吸引力，我们就越喜欢它。
The less attractive the object, the less we love it.
物体吸引力越小，我们就越不喜欢它。
That is human love.
那就是人类的爱。
That is why we love our family members more than strangers.
这就是为什么我们爱自己的家人多过爱陌生人的原因。
And when we love others, we expect them to love us back.
而且当我们爱他人的时候，我们也会希望他们也能爱我们。
And here is the mistake that we often make.
这是我们经常犯的错误。
we often understand God's love in the way that we understand human love.
我们通常以理解人类爱的方式去理解神的爱。
So we think that God must only love those who love him.
因此我们认为神只能爱那些爱他的人。
Or that his love depends on how good we are.
或是他的爱取决于我们有多好。
That is a common mistake that many people make.
这是人们常犯的错误。
But God's love is not like human love.
但是神的爱不像人类的爱。
God's love is unconditional.
神的爱是无条件的。
That is, it is based on his character, his nature.
神的爱是基于他的本性和性情。
His love is completely independent of the attractiveness, the beauty, the worth, and the value of the object.
他的爱完全不取决于物体的吸引力、物体的美丽、物体的价值和是否配得。
He loves us not on the basis of how good we are.
他爱我们不是基于我们有多好。
Or what we have done.
或做过什么事。
But on the basis of his grace.
而是基于他的恩典。
God sent his son to die for us while we were still sinners.
神是在当我们还是罪人，我们还是他的敌人时，差遣他的儿子为我们而死的。
How can you be sure that God loves you?
你如何确定神爱你呢？
Paul says, look at the cross.
保罗说，看看十字架。
The cross is the ultimate proof of God's love for you.
十字架是神对你的爱的终极证明。
Through the cross, we see just how much God loves us.
通过十字架，我们看到神有多么的爱我们。
How much is God willing to give?
神愿意付出多少呢?
He is willing to give everything.
他愿意付出一切。
Even his one and only son.
甚至是他唯一的儿子。
So we have both subjective and objective proof of God's love.
因此我们有着主观和客观的证据去证明神的爱。
The first is the work of the Holy Spirit.Which pours the love of God into our hearts.
首先是圣灵的工作，他将神的爱浇灌到我们的心中。
That is subjective and experiential.
这是主观的，而且是可以经历的。
The second is the death of his son 2,000 years ago at the cross.
第二是他的儿子在2000多年前在十字架上的死。
That is objective and historical.
那是客观的和有历史证明的。
The third proof of God's love is a logical one.
神的爱的第三个证据是合乎逻辑的。
Through his life.
就是通过他的生命。
Because Jesus didn't stay dead.
因为耶稣没有死。
God raised him back to life on the third day.
神在第三天将他复活。
And that is important.
这很重要。
Because if Jesus is alive,then we can be even more sure of God's love for us.
因为如果耶稣还活着，那么我们就可以更加确定神对我们的爱。
Look at verses 9 to 10.
第九到第十节里面说到，现在我们既靠着他的血称义，就更要借着他免去神的愤怒。因为我们做仇敌的时候，且借着神儿子的死得与神和好。既已和好，就更要因他的身得救了。
Here, Paul uses a greater to lesser argument.
保罗在这里使用了从难到易的论点。
He starts with the greater.
他从难的开始。
If God saved us from his wrath while we were still his enemy, how much more will he continue to save us now that we have become children of God.
如果神在我们还是他的敌人的时候，将我们从他的愤怒中拯救出来，那么既然现在我们已是神的儿女，神不是更会将我们从他的愤怒中拯救出来吗？
The second is far easier than the first, isn't it?
第二个比第一个要容易得多，不是吗？
If Jesus died to reconcile us to God, how much more will He keep us reconciled to God now that He is alive?
如果耶稣的死是为了使我们与神和好，那么既然他现在还活着，那么他不是更会让我们继续与神和好吗？
If sin could not stop God from loving us before we were saved, how much more will God continue to love us now that we are saved?
如果罪不能阻止神在我们得救之前去爱我们，既然现在我们已得救，那么有什么罪可以阻止神去爱我们呢？
Let me boil it down to an irreducible minimum.
让我简单的来说一下。
God always finishes what he started.
神总会完成他所开始的一切。
If he started our salvation, he will surely finish it.
如果他开始了我们的救赎，他一定会完成的。
Here we have one of the strongest promises of God's keeping power.
在这里，我们有着神的持守能力的最强有力的应许之一。
H.A. Ironside was a famous preacher in the early 20th century.
艾朗塞是20世纪初期的著名传教士。
One day, an elderly man who was having doubts about his salvation came up to Ironside and said,
有一天，一位对自己的救赎充满怀疑的老人来到艾朗塞面前说
I'll get Helen to read it out.
他说，除非我知道自己已经得救，否则我不会继续下去，或是要确定这一点就毫无希望了。我想要一个明确的见证人，这是我不能弄错的一点。
Ironside then replied this man,Suppose you had a vision of an angel who told you your sins were forgiven. Would that be enough to rest on?
艾朗塞回答这个人，假设有一个天使告诉你，你的罪已得赦免，这样足够让你安心了吗？
Yes, I think it would. An angel would be right.
会的，我认为会让我安心的，天使应该是对的。
Ironside then continued, But suppose on your deathbed, Satan came and said,I was that angel transformed to deceive you. What would you say then?
艾朗塞接着说，但是假设撒旦在你临死之前来到你的面前对你说，我就是当时的那个天使化身去欺骗了你，你会怎么说呢？
This made the man speechless.
这使那个老人无语了。
Ironside then went on to say,God has given us something more dependable than the voice of an angel. He has given us his son, who died for our sins, and he has testified in his word that if we trust him, all our sins are gone.
艾朗塞接着说，神给了我们比天使的声音更可靠的东西，就是他赐给了我们他的儿子，他为我们的罪而死，他已经用自己的话证明了。如果我们相信他，我们所有的罪都将被除去。
He then took out the Bible and turned to 1 John chapter 5 verse 13.
然后艾朗塞拿出圣经，读了约翰一书五章十三节。
And get Helen to read it out.
这里说道，我将这些话写给你们信奉神儿子之名的人，要叫你们知道自己有永生。
Ironside then said to the man,Is that not enough to rest on?
然后那个艾朗塞对那个老人说，这难道还不够让你安心吗？
It is a letter from heaven expressly to you.
这是天国寄给你的快信。
After those words, the man was greatly comforted and he never doubted his salvation again.
讲完这些话后，那个老人得到了极大的安慰，他也不再怀疑自己的救赎了。
What is the most reliable proof of God's love?
神的爱最可靠的证据是什么呢？
How can we know for sure that God loves us?
我们怎么能确定我们已经得救了呢？
The word of God.
就是凭着神的话。
And what does God's word say?
神的话是怎么说的？
Romans chapter 8, one of my favorite passages of the Bible says this.
在罗马书八章里面有我最喜欢的圣经经文之一，这里说道：因为我深信，无论是死是生，是天使，是掌权的，是有能的，是现在的事，是将来的事，是高处的，是低处的，是别的受造之物，都不能叫我们与神的爱隔绝。这爱是在我们的主耶稣基督里的。
When Christians doubt whether they are saved, do you know what that is a symptom of?
当基督徒怀疑他们是否得救时，你知道那是什么症状吗？
It is a symptom of unbelief.
那是不信的症状。
They are not trusting in God's word.
他们没有相信神的话。
Instead of believing in God's word, they are believing in their feelings.
与其相信神的话，他们却相信自己的感觉。
Instead of relying on the work of Christ, they are relying on themselves, on their own works.
与其去信靠基督的作为，他们却去信靠自己的功劳。
And that always results in miserable, depressed Christians who have no joy in their life.
这种症状总是导致了生命中没有喜乐、沮丧的基督徒。
Because nothing is more burdensome than trying to earn God's favor by your own efforts.
因为没有什么负担比要尝试通过自己的努力去赚得神的恩典更重的负担了。
That is not how those who have received the love of God ought to behave.
那不是那些已经接受了神的爱的人应该有的行为。
How should we respond to God's love?
我们应该如何回应神的爱呢？
Look at verse 11.
第十一节里面说道：不但如此，我们既借着我主耶稣基督得与神和好，也就借着他以神为乐。
What does God's love produce?
神的爱会结出什么呢？
It produces joy.
神的爱会结出喜乐。
Real joy.
真正的喜乐
，abiding joy，
永恒的喜乐
，a joy that is grounded in the certainty of God's love for us，
一种基于神对我们永恒不变的爱的喜乐。
As John Stott put it, we Christians should be the most positive people in the world.
正如神学家约翰·施托德所说。我们基督徒应该是世界上最积极乐观的人。
Joy is one of the first telltale signs of someone who has been touched by the love of God.
被神的爱所浇灌过的人的第一个明显的迹象就是他们是蛮有喜乐的人。
So how sure are you of God's love?
那么你如何确定神对你的爱呢？
How, from a scale of 1 to 10, how confident are you of getting into heaven.
从一到十的比例，你对进入天堂有多少信心呢？
If you are not that confident, maybe you need to take the focus off yourself.
如果你没有很多信心，也许你需要把焦点从自己身上移开。
Off your weaknesses and failures.
把焦点从自己的弱点和失败上移开。
And focus more on the cross.
而更多的去专注于十字架上。
On what Jesus did to save you.
去专注于基督为拯救你所做的一切。
Consider the enormous price that God paid to save you.
去思想一下神为彰显他对你的爱所付出的巨大的代价。
And instead of wallowing in guilt, rejoice.
与其让自己活在内疚中，你却要欢喜快乐。
Rejoice in what the Lord has done for us.
要因主为我们所做的而欢喜。
When the devil tries to sow doubts into our minds, praise and worship is the best way to make the devil flee.
当魔鬼试图向你的心中撒下怀疑时，赞美和敬拜是使他远离的最好方法。
Ask the Holy Spirit to pour afresh the love of God into your heart.
要请求圣灵将神的爱重新浇灌到你的心里。
And rest confidently in the promises of God's word.
并有信心地安息在神的应许里。
Let us pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
And I'll get Helen to do the prayer for us based on Ephesians chapter 3.
我们现在以以弗所书第三章这里来祷告。亲爱的天父，我为到今天所有在庆听的人去祷告，愿他们爱心有根有基，能以和众圣徒一同明白基督的爱是何等长阔高深，并知道这爱是过于人所能测度的，便叫神一切所充满的充满了他们。愿你今天将圣灵浇灌到我们的心中，使我们可以充满神的爱。对于那些还没有相信耶稣的人，愿他们知道你有多爱他们。我们奉耶稣的名祈求祷告，阿们。
感谢大家参加今天的恩典真理基督教会的线上崇拜，我们今天的崇拜就到这里了。如果你有感动想要奉献，请留意屏幕上方的银行信息，可以通过银行转账的方式进行奉献，也可以关注我们的 Facebook 主页，然后获取最新信息。再见。